Hello everyone, let's talk about superspreaders. Assume there are 10 suspects at the scene of the crime. All of them were infected really, really quickly, and we know that the virus transmits from human to human. Only one person was infected in the beginning. Who is this person most likely to be? On our detective board, we have information about the suspects and their contact with each other. We shall call this our contact network. At first glance, you might say, it's not much of a case. Obviously, the person with the most contact will be the culprit. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, A has the most contact. A is the super spreader then, right? But is the number of contact the only thing that matters? Let's look at the bigger picture. Focusing just on the contact between them reveals that these 10 suspects can be divided into two groups, two infection clusters, cluster 1 and cluster 2. If D in cluster 1 was infected and then F in cluster 2 somehow got infected, naturally you would wonder, how did this happen? One way is that D infected H and then C and then G and then F. This is one path of infection from G to F. Or D could have infected A, who in turn infected C and then G and then F. This is an alternative path for D to infect F. The virus does not necessarily have to go through A, since there are a few paths, but it has to go through C and G. Without C or G, the two clusters would be completely separated. A is only in contact with the people in cluster 1, but its neighbor C is in contact with G, who is in cluster 2. C and G have super spreading powers, since their contacts are more diverse. In this way, C and G are super spreaders, even though they have fewer contacts than A. Now, how do we convince others that this is true? We need solid numbers. We can represent a network with a mathematical object called a graph. A graph is defined by its vertices. There are 10 vertices in this graph, and its edges. There are 12 edges in this graph. The number of edges connected to each vertex is known as the degree of a graph. Since there are 4 edges attached to A, then the degree of A is 4. The 2 edges attached to B gives B a degree of 2. Similarly, counting the edges yields degree of vertices C to J. By sorting degree from largest to smallest, we get a ranking. And when we rank by degree, A is number 1. Therefore, we can say that A is a super spreader when we use degree. Between the centrality measures how much a vertex is situated between other vertices. For example, in order for D to reach F, it has to go through C. Therefore, C is said to be between D and F. However, for D to reach F, it does not necessarily have to go through A. So A is not always between D and F. The between the centrality of a vertex represents how many times a particular vertex comes between other vertices. It quantifies how important a vertex is to the connection between other vertices. We can rank by between the centrality from largest to smallest. C and G are now top of the chart. Therefore, we can use between the centrality to prove our acquisition of C and G as the super spreaders. to identify COVID-19 superspreaders, both degree and betweenness centrality should be taken into account, along with other concepts in graph theory and network analysis. In one of our previous cases, we simulated possible spreading scenarios involving 148 students. In these scenarios, the students are either susceptible, infected, or immune. By targeting students with high betweenness centralities, the curve of infection was flattened faster compared to when we targeted students with high degree. Therefore, the graph and the clusters within the graph determine who are the superspreaders. Degree and betweenness centralities are two mathematical tools that can help us answer questions about specific networks. Having various mathematical tools in your arsenal is crucial to find the truth. Thank you for solving cases with me today. If you want to be a mathematical detective yourself, feel free to check out our reports of previous cases linked below. I am Fatimah Abdul Razak, and I do detective work with mathematics.